Calvary greetings in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. May his righteousness, peace, grace, love and kindness be upon us this holy week in the name of Jesus. Let us pray. He is the King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords. His name is Jesus, 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 J-E-S-U-S. He is the King, he is the King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords. His name is Jesus, 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 J-E-S-U-S, he is the King. Everlasting Father, indeed you are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Your reign is from everlasting to everlasting because you are the eternal Creator, the Maker of all things in heaven and on earth. We worship you. We glorify your holy name. We pray, O Lord, that because you are the Lord of times and season, this holy week, you will reveal yourself to your people in the name of Jesus. Father, it is written that the entrance of your word give light and understanding to the simple. Let the word that I will speak give light and understanding to those who are yet in darkness, that the grace of salvation may be ministered to all mankind in the name of Jesus. Draw many out of darkness into your marvelous light in the name of Jesus. You send forth your word, you heal their diseases and deliver them from their infirmities. Let the word that I speak cause souls to be saved, healings to be wrought, your name to be glorified in the name of Jesus Christ. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of the heart of your people be now and always acceptable to you, our Lord and our Redeemer. Amen. Today being Monday, the second day in the Holy Week in the year 2020, as we meditate on the suffering and the passion of our Lord Jesus Christ, I want us to reflect and learn one or two lessons from the sermon that I will preach today. The title of the sermon is Jesus Christ, our Great High Priest. The title of the sermon is Jesus Christ, our Great High Priest. The text of the sermon is Hebrews chapter 4, verse 14 to 16. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 14 to 16. And I read, seeing that we have a great high priest that is passed into the heavens, Jesus, Son of God, let us hold fast to our profession. Verse 15, for we have not an high priest which cannot be touched with the feelings of our infirmities, but was in all points tempted like we are, yet without sin. Let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. We are looking at the topic, Jesus Christ, our Great High Priest. In the Jewish tradition, during the Bible times, the high priest is the highest religious authority in Israel. It was the duty of the high priest once in a year to enter into the holies of holies to make sacrifice for the atonement of the sin of the nation of Israel. Leviticus chapter 16. Jesus, our great high priest, is also the paschal lamb, the Lamb of God without blemish, the Lamb of God that took away the sin of the world. He yielded himself a sacrifice once and for all for the atonement of the sin of the whole world. Isaiah chapter 53 verse 10. Matthew chapter 26 verse 26 to 28. 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 20 to 21. Dear people of God, it is worthy of note that the priesthood of Jesus Christ is not of this world. It is of heaven. The priesthood of Jesus Christ is divine. It is ordained by the Almighty God Himself. The priesthood of Jesus Christ is extraordinary. It is supernatural. The priesthood of Jesus Christ is superior to all others. It is better, more glorious, more powerful, more effectful, more effective than the priesthood of Aaron and the Levitical priests. Jesus' ordination as a priest is divine and holy. His consecration as a high priest is powerful, is purposeful, and it is done not by man, not by angels, but by God Himself. The Bible says, "The Lord has sworn and will not change His mind. You are priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek." Psalm 110, verse 4. Hebrews chapter 6, verse 20 further confirms the divine nature of the priesthood of Jesus Christ. And I quote Hebrews chapter 6, verse 20. Jesus has entered as a forerunner for us, having become a high priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek. Hebrews 7:17 says, "For it is attested of him, you are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek." Jesus' priesthood can be compared to no other. It is uniquely that of Jesus Christ, our Lord. It is ordained by God. It is divine. Just as His kingdom is from everlasting to everlasting, the priesthood of our Lord Jesus Christ is also everlasting. It is forever. The Bible says His priesthood is superior to all others. Hebrews 7 verse 11. Hebrews chapter 7 verse 11 says, "His priesthood is perfect." Hebrews chapter 8 verse 6 says, "His priesthood is excellent." And I read Hebrews 8:16. "He has obtained a more excellent ministry by as much as he is the mediator of a better covenant which has been enacted on a better promise." His priesthood is excellent. The most excellency is Jesus. Shout hallelujah, amen. 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 Amen, hallelujah. Amen, hallelujah, amen. Amen, hallelujah. Amen, hallelujah. Amen, hallelujah, oh, amen, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, amen, hallelujah. Hallelujah, amen, amen, hallelujah, amen. Amen, hallelujah, amen, amen, hallelujah, amen. Shout hallelujah, oh, hallelujah, oh, hallelujah, amen, amen, hallelujah, amen. The most excellency is Jesus. Sing hallelujah, amen, hallelujah. Most excellency is Jesus. Shout hallelujah, amen. Paul in the book of Hebrews will have us believe that the priesthood of our Lord Jesus Christ is superior to any other priesthood. His priesthood, the ministry of his priesthood, is the most excellent of all. Jesus Christ, our great high priest, is also our paschal lamb. He died for us. He made a once and for all sacrifice on the cross at Calvary so that you and I may have the newness of life. As we have read from Hebrews chapter 8 verse 6, he has entered into a new covenant. He's the mediator of a new covenant between man and God. And this covenant and this promise is for the benefit of mankind. It is for your benefit. It is for my benefit. Jesus, to become the high priest, suffered greatly. He suffered ridicule. He suffered shame. He suffered death upon the cross. He died that we may have life and have it more abundantly. From his suffering, he learned obedience, even obedient unto death. Beloved in Christ, let us not let the death of Christ be in vain. Let us not let the blood that was shed in Calvary be in vain. Rather, let that blood be for us the blood of redemption, the blood that will redeem us from the clutches of sin and Satan, the blood that will redeem us from darkness into the light of salvation. I pray that the suffering of Christ will not be in vain over you, over me, and over our loved ones in the name of Jesus Christ. Christ is the great high priest. He is the redeemer. He is the bishop of our soul. He is our provider. All good and perfect gift is from him. This Holy Week, as we meditate on his suffering, on his passion, let us draw near to the throne of grace that we may receive mercy. People of God, not only has Christ died, he has risen again. He is seated at the right hand of God as a mediator, interceding for you and for me. Let us read what Paul has written in Romans chapter 8 verse 34. Romans chapter 8 verse 34. Christ has not come to condemn, neither has he come to judge as yet. That is why Romans 8 34 says, he who is he that condemneth? Is it Christ that died? Yea, that is risen again. Who is even seated at the right hand of God, who make intercession for us? Christ do not want the death of sinners. He's not judging us. He's not condemning us. The time for judgment and condemnation will come. The time of redemption and salvation is there. Draw near to him, that the high priest of the new covenant may grant you salvation and eternal life. Let us pray. Have you been to Jesus for the cleansing balm? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed? Are you washed in the blood? In the blood, in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb. Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Jesus is inviting you this day, this Holy Week, to depart from the way of sin and destruction, to come and be washed in his blood and be given the newness of life. Let us pray. Our Lord and our God, as you have given me grace, I have spoken.
Praise
give grace that the word that I have spoken, as many that will hear it, will yield their life to you as the Lord and Savior, that the heavens will rejoice upon their salvation in the name of Jesus. Thank you, gracious Father, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest droughts and storms.